Kako je poti traži trepavice? Jednom davno, prije dva tjedna, tri su brata ušlo u WC u školi pod malim odmorom. Sjeli su na WC školjke. U jednom trenutku iz svih troje školjki je nestala voda i neka sila je počela vući njihove hlače kao neka crna rupa. Dok se oni dozivali do mara, školjke su im vukle i napokon povukle hlače. On im nije mogao pomoći, ali se onda sjetio da ima dva para hlača njihove veličine. Ljutiša i Marom su brzo uzeli ta dva para, pa je Potjeh ostao u svojim gačicama na suprinu. Bio je tužen jer su stradale njegove trapeze, koje su bile najljepše u cijeloj školi. Vuče ih je vratio. Pozdrav je sa svojom račom. Zatim je otišao na drugi kraj škole jer u onom još nije prestala raditi silu. Stao je u školu i pustio vodu. Kad je kroz cijevi koje su djelovali kao toboran došao u kanalizaciju, iznenadio se što je vidio. To je bilo kao raj za životinje. Štakovi, partijane, studenti, miševi, pušteljice, navijačice i još mnoge druge životinje. Čak je vidio i svoju gibicu Gloriju, a ona je brzo otišla. A onda je u daljini čuo nekoga. Ove traperice su preuske. Kad je otišao da pogleda tko je to bio. To je bio Klonk. Tebe Klonk je serija bila otkazana nakon jednog lošeg vica. Klonk je uočio Potjeha. Počela je borba. Klonk je bacio svoj crveni nos koji je zapravo bila bomba. Potjeh je izbjegao i udario Klonku pod njegove stražnice. Tog dana bol u Klonkovoj stražnici nikad nije prestao. Klonko sam nesvjesnio pa mu je Potjeh uzeo trapice. Kad je izašao iz kanalizacije, naišao se u Belgiji, da uzeo drugu rutu. Vratio se u školu baš kad je zvonu zvonilo i završio mali odmor. Vratio se na nastavu i svi su živjeli dugo i sretno. Naravno, svi osim Klonka.
Palunko and his mobile phone. Once upon a time, there was a pupil called Palunko. He didn't have any friends. He was very lonely. Then he met a boy called Mario. They became friends. One day, as he was passing by some shop windows, he saw the most beautiful mobile he had ever seen before. It was elastic and thin as a lath. He wanted it so badly, but he didn't have any money to buy it. So he made a plan to steal it. He talked Marun and the other boy called Peter into it. They agreed to help Palunko stealing the mobile phone. One day they walked into the shop. Marun and Peter tried to steal some mobile phones, but they were caught. While the security man was calling the police, Palunko managed to steal his precious mobile phone. His friends were arrested. They thought that Palunko would help them, but he didn't care. He had his mobile phone. That was all that mattered to him at that moment. Marun and Peter were punished and even put in jail for some time. Meanwhile, Palunko became addicted to his mobile phone. He spent all his time on it. Then he became lonely again. He didn't have any friends. When Marun and Peter got out of the prison, they visited Palunko. They were so angry with him, they took his precious mobile phone and smashed it. Palunko was relieved. He begged them to become his friends again. They agreed.